Меня до Мурманска находится в хвосте состава. Спасибо за внимание.
Hilarious.
Filming.
Kidding. This is what Jeff and I do every night.
Yeah, I gotta get some stuff on this.
Crap. Missed the village.
So I have this Bulgarian math teacher. I think that would be real good. Because I suck at math and maybe I can like charm her by speaking.
My child.
Wow, that's cool. Welcome to Moscow, baby.
Make a drive over there. So, but you are to take the pictures from the bus, actually, through the window of the bus, and later on, when we'll park, you will have your chance. So now the students are having their examinations, which will last till the end of June, July and August. These are the months for vacation. And we have two terms each year. At the end of each term, they pass examination. So we start schooling children at the age of 7 or 6. It depends on parents, you know, when they want to send their child to school to build here a big stadium.
Undertake.
So 1957-58, the Moscow Luzhniki Stadium was built. You will see it very well. With Napoleon, and it's really one of the most. Пану Марвату, да, по улице Горького вы хотите? Да, можем. Хорошо, хорошо, ладно, хорошо. Валя.
Тогда не там, мы поворачиваем на этом самом.
The one over there in the depth of the buildings which are now to your right and to your left are the creations of the 60s at the time of Brezhnev. They were placed here, the late 60s, and this is the concentration of the nightlife in Moscow. There are lots of nightclubs, casinos and disco bars and so on, lots of restaurants and souvenir shops, by the way. Here it's a nice place to visit, both in the daytime and at night, in the evening. The famous Moscow bookstore is now to the left, at his wedding ceremony when he married the first beauty of Moscow.
Yeah. Check out.
That
is very interesting. What did this guy do? Here's the heart surgeon. Alright. Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry. Just take a picture, but it wasn't a very good picture. Not really sure what kind of bird it is. That's crazy.
$10 an hour?
Free departure shot. It's gonna get hotter.
Thank you. So how long have you been in the country and what's how long you've traveled around? You were up in St. Petersburg. Yeah.
That's interesting.
You got to be kidding me.
Oh my god. Sweet.
First, I want to welcome you to Spasso House, which is the residence of the American Ambassador. I am not the American Ambassador. I'm the number two here. The Ambassador is away, and he agreed when I asked him if I could make an exception and actually do the briefing here at his house because of Christine Rydel. I said, this is a special day for me. So he agreed, and he just asked that we not trash the place. And I said, well, these are Grand Valley students. I'm not sure I can make any promises, but... Yeah, I was just going to say, but I know that Christine is good for keeping students in line, so... this house is actually more than the Ambassador's residence. It's also something like the American Embassy Cultural Center, Community Center. We use this house a lot for receptions, events, and concerts, and I'll show you some of the various spaces that we use this a lot for over the last three years that I've been in Moscow. And this is actually the second posting that I've had here. I served my first tour as a young Foreign Service officer 20 years ago, and I actually lived in Spasso House as the assistant, the aide to the ambassador then, and I had a little apartment right around the corner here, which has been since turned into a green room. This house was actually built by one of the first Russian oligarchs. But these were the oligarchs who caused the first Russian Revolution in 1917. There was a sugar merchant who made a lot of money and had this house built around 1911. And he lived in here for a couple of years, and then after the communist takeover, it was expropriated by the Russian and Soviet government. It served for a while as the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, or then it was called the Commissariat, or Commissariat of Foreign Relations. And the foreign minister at that time, Chicherin, actually lived in this house for a while. And during that time, the United States and Russia, or the Soviet Union, didn't have diplomatic relations. We broke diplomatic relations with the Soviet Union after the Bolsheviks took over in 1918. And we didn't reestablish relations until President Roosevelt, FDR, came in 1933. At that point, he sent a team over here saying, we need to establish an embassy and we need to find a proper residence for the ambassador to live in and an office building, a chancery for the embassy. So Ambassador William Bullitt and a young diplomat named George Kennan came to Moscow in 1933. They were shown this house and they said, we'll take it. We don't own the house, we pay rent on it. But ever since 1933, every U.S. ambassador, first to the Soviet Union and now to Russia, has lived in this house. Even by Moscow standards, it's pretty massive in terms of pre-revolutionary mansions. It's in the equivalent of the Russian Registry of Historical Properties. And the U.S. government has done a lot of work here and spent, not a lot, but some taxpayer dollars to do some of the upgrades. The Russian government also has paid money to upgrade the house a little bit. The ambassador's private quarters are upstairs. He has a bedroom, drawing room, small kitchen, an office. And then there are guest rooms up on the other side of the second floor where, for instance, President Nixon stayed, Vice President Bush, President Bush has stayed here. And when the ambassador has personal guests, they also stay at Spasso House. But most of the life of the house goes on here on the first floor. This room, called the chandelier room, appropriately enough, is the site where we have a lot of diplomatic receptions and cultural receptions. And the chandelier was at one time the largest chandelier in Moscow. I'm not sure if that's still true, but it's definitely one of the largest. The painting, the yellow coffering in the ceiling, was done in the mid-1980s when we had an architect out here who did some scraping and determined that that was the original color. And that was the time that I actually lived in this house, music for his opera, Love for Three Oranges, back in the 1930s. And in fact, the ambassador here in 1933-34, William Bullitt, used to throw these extravagant parties. And one of the parties, the most famous party ever thrown in Spaso House, was the inspiration for the grand Satan's Ball described in a book that Christine first gave me to read called The Master and Margarita. This is one of the parties that Bulgakov attended in Spaso House was the inspiration for the site of Satan's Ball. And back in October, Mrs. Birschbau, the ambassador's wife, threw a party here. We didn't call it Satan's Ball, we call it the Master and Margarita Ball. But we had a lot of artifacts here from Bulgakov area. We had people walking around dressed as big cats.
Nobody came naked.
And the devil, no. This is U.S. government property. We do have to be careful. And as you can see, we have a lot of space in the house, and it's a very versatile building, and we can do a lot of different things here. This is a room that we call the state dining room, and when the ambassador has dinners or lunches for anything over 14 people, you can get about 26 people here around the table. He'll host them in this room, and I have lots of memories in this room of dinners with people like Van Cliburn, one night with John Denver and Jim Henson, the creator of the Muppets back in the 1980s. Lots of famous personages migrate through Moscow, and a lot of them, if they have an American connection, end up at Spaso House. It's one of the great perks of working here, is you get to meet some really fascinating people. I didn't even mention all of the congressmen, senators, presidents that have been through here, writers. It's just a fantastic place. Wednesday night, I'm here in a room which was actually built in the 1930s. The ballroom was actually added to the original mansion by Ambassador Bullitt. We decided he didn't quite have enough space to entertain in style, so we built this room which has been used in the 80s, we used to use it for film showings. There was a projection booth up there. The screen dropped out here, and we'd have 200 or 300 people in and show them the latest version of Star Wars or Sophie's Choice. Tootsie, first time I ever saw Tootsie, the movie Tootsie was in this room. We also have used it for playing broomball, and even basketball was played in here on a couple of occasions when they actually brought in baskets and backboards. But now we use it mostly for concerts, and you can fit about 200-250 people in here comfortably, and it's a great location. Investors who want to come in from the West, or Russians who have money, who want to invest their money internally, domestically.
open small business. There are tremendous disincentives here. A lot of corruption, tremendous corruption at sort of the middle levels. By one account in an article I read, for a small businessman in a town like Tula, which is a decent-sized town about 3 hours south of here, to open up something like, let's say, a small grocery store, he needed to get 138 signatures from various parts of the bureaucracy. And each one of those signatures doesn't come for free. It costs something. And the efforts to deal with that kind of corruption at that level, not to mention higher level corruption where whole businesses are sort of being bought and sold through shady deals, it has been extremely difficult for Putin or the government here to come to terms with, because everybody is essentially getting well off of the system. No one has a very strong stake in changing. And the fact that we rail about this and we say to Russia, you know, it's going to be very difficult for you to get into the WTO, World Trade Organization, terms that you want to see if you don't get a handle on this, they say, yeah, we agree with you, but it's a very, very difficult problem to address. The first step, I would say, is making it part of the political debate here. You've got to at least have politicians who would stand up and say, corruption is our number one domestic enemy. And right now, because the political situation here is also kind of one-sided, we don't have a lot of that going on. But it's a huge problem.
Across the road and then
you send that traffic. Still is. Yeah. Thank you.
socialist realism. What?
Thank you.
Recording. Arbat Street. In the rain. Try to put this away soon. Close up on. My camera. So I get this statue really quick. It's kind of neat. It's getting worse. Yeah. Sorry. Moscow was founded by cobblers. Meet you. This is kind of. Hold a second. Restaurant?
We'll be right back. Impact in 5 seconds. 4, three, two.
Поехать, чтобы в Европу по-настоящему немного въехать. Работая долго на жирного урода, мне помогала мечта звезда нового года. Погода, зима, не радовали холода. Я не жалел себя, ведь сумма велика. Валюта тяжела, виза нелегка. Ага, поставлена задача, передо мною цель близка. Я получил сполна, от этого кружилась голова. За бабки я купил в оба конца билеты, визу. В плеере играл из Вутанга Риза. Лети, друг, сказал, твой рейс Москва-Нью-Йорк. Он подал мне идею для записи этих строк. Я летел в Бруклин и Бронкс повеселиться. И помнить обещал о Москве, моей столице. Я лечу в Нью-Йорк.
Москва, Нью-Йорк, Нью-Йорк, Москва. 12 часов разделяют эти города. Москва, Нью-Йорк, Нью-Йорк, Москва. Рэп тот и там, музыка навсегда. Музыка навсегда, хип-хоп. Музыка навсегда, хип-хоп. Музыка навсегда, только рэп. Музыка навсегда, только рэп.
Aaron was buried there, and it was only in 1839 that actual Mufti's remains to the origin of that one on this grave was made.
I think that you gathered us all here today for a moment.
Shut up! I like that idea, Will.
You're illegal now.
This is me and the rest of the trip. But that way he'll think that I missed him.
stood there pretending. What did I say? I'm not sure. Stop snapping. You got me. Well, I've got very little. The question is, what is the meaning of this conversation? I'm not sure, eh? I just asked if you were awake. And what did I say? That was the part I didn't understand. That did it. I had no choice but to cancel the sleep mode and go back on duty. I opened both eyes and sat up. Grover, do you have any idea what you're talking about? Not really. I was just trying to make conversation. I get bored sometimes. If I had to live with that time brain of yours, I'd get bored too.
This is where she gets it.
What was the point?
Colors. Lena, what's the name of this town?
Muranova.
Muranova. Muranova.
Много людей селилось.
Там храм открыт.
Miracle making, like she says there. It heals. Many people got healed there.
We have another one.
Is that the church? What is Pete doing? Apparently Pete's helping plant some flowers. Pete's got a friend.
Watching the time at all?
No, but she asked me to help.
Okay, great.
That's beautiful. I didn't. get it. What else can you both drink? Oh. Just got 18, so started this place for artists. Exacto.
Grandfather or grand-grandfather, and in Russia we changed the meaning, and so we called it Excluding. That's all.
Thank you.
From the gentleman, they wouldn't feel bad. Maybe.
Baba Yaga's house. The gnomes. Here's me getting lost in the woods in Russia. Vladimir Witch Project. That's great.
Yes.
Wow.
Ha ha ha.